Welcome, viewers. This is Winch here. So Armored Kill is out, and if I had one word to summarize my feelings for this game, I am overwhelmed with joy. By far the best Battlefield 3 experience I've had yet to date, and I've barely even scratched the surface playing this game. I just finally got around to getting some gameplay on. Yes, I do have a life outside Battlefield 3. It's called a job, and unfortunately I wasn't able to play it on launch day, but I want to cover the AC-130 because this is what I was looking forward to the most. I was all giddy as like a, a little kid on Christmas Eve or something. I just couldn't wait to get in this thing and reminisce about my old days of Modern Warfare 2. That was my favorite thing about Modern Warfare 2 was that kill streak. And I was just, I was blown away that the DICE was going to bring this into Armored Kill. This is why I love this game so much, is because of, how they continually expand this with premium. All the different DLCs, how it changes the feel of the game completely in just one DLC. And this is a perfect example. And look at this triple kill. Boom. Look at those bodies fly. Yeah, let's see it again in slow-mo, because get used to it. You're going to see that a lot. And you saw those first two scoreboards? Yes. What I want to talk about in this video is the AC-130 overpowered, because that's what everybody's going to start saying in this footage. Right off the bat, everybody's going to start having concerns regarding this, so I want to address them head-on, and let's just open a discussion as well as explain this vehicle to you so you know kind of what you're getting into, because I was clueless getting into this right off the bat, and explain what you can expect with this vehicle, how to handle it, the loadouts, your difficulties, your obstacles, and kind of show you how to obtain some beast gameplay, as I did, because you saw those two scoreboards. I went 48-4 on one match. You saw my co-player there, MHMCC, getting a comparable score to that. And the next match, I think I went 30-2. So obviously a powerful vehicle. I would have to say I've never got kill streaks like that. And look, I mean, just the amount of devastation you unleash on this is—it's almost incomprehensible in terms of what you can do with this vehicle. One other thing I want to mention about Armored Kill before I go into depth on the AC-130 is it has opened a new gateway for me in terms of my Battlefield 3 gameplay with Rush. Rush is incredible on this DLC content. The maps are phenomenal, and I don't know what they've done in terms of the graphical representation for the PlayStation, but I have almost zero frame rate issues. Everything looks brighter, crisper, sharper. No frame rate issues. It's almost like a new game in a lot of ways. It's much more fluid. Again, the graphics, you'd think the size of these maps would be a factor, but it's not. Beautifully made, lots of fun. It's a completely different game, guys. That's the best way I can describe it, and it's incredible. I'll post a formal review of this as I get some more gameplay, but I've kind of already spoiled that as much as I've talked about how much I like this already. But Rush is by far the most fun game mode, and that's not just in the AC-130. Obviously in the AC-130 you're going to have much more potential to spawn camp, which is kind of what I'm doing here, but that, as opposed to playing Conquest, the AC-130 is, I think, much more deadly in Rush, but it still can be dealt with. First of all, I want to just kind of give you some basics on the AC-130. There's two gunner positions on this thing, and I'm in the aft portion, which is where the big gun is. This is a 105mm cannon that I'm using right here, and basically this cannon has a FLIR sight on it, so I can see heat just like you can a lot of vehicles. And now what I just switched to there was my anti-air gunner position. So the other position is a 40mm cannon position, and it does not have a FLIR sight, so you're basically just looking visually. You can see there's two zoom options, a far and a near zoom. So you basically, each gunner has its own position in its own cannon. You can't switch between the two cannons if there's another player in the AC-130 with you. And it's not controlled by another pilot. It's strictly you have two gunners in this thing. Also, you hear me shooting flares right there? Each gunner has its own set of flares. So it's all about teamwork, like Battlefield 3 is all about as usual. It's about communicating with your player, coordinating when to deploy flares. So you shoot your set of flares, and you have your teammate, whenever you get another stinger or whatever, it's, jet shooting something at Heatseeker at you, you'll have him deploy his flares. So it kind of increases your survivability in this vehicle. Also, you'll notice that the damage we're taking, this aircraft does not regenerate its damage. So what damage you take is cumulative. It will not repair itself. So over time, you will get destroyed by whatever it is. And what you'll see a lot of times is Stingers. You just ground surface to air missiles are your biggest threat. I prioritize on those more than just about anything other than the enemy aircraft, which like the Frogfoot or any kind of jets, Hornet, it doesn't matter. This thing's very vulnerable from the ground up. So if you're in a jet and you attack from the lower ground up, you basically there's nothing you can do. And there is me obtaining the air warfare medal. I mean, this is very early in this gameplay with this. I was just destroying with this thing, getting mad points, kill streaks, medals, lots of points with this thing. But again, it's very vulnerable from the ground. So if you're in a jet, if you attack from the underside of the aircraft, you can't even turn your anti-air turrets that direction. And look at these points. Look how many cumulative points I've got right at this point. 1,100 points, there's 1,200 points. It keeps going. You know how your points cumulatively go up the quicker you get kills? You know, the more kills you get, the quicker you get, the more points you get as a result. There's 1,400. And basically, what you got to do with this cannon is it's not easy to do. Let me tell you right off the bat, this is easier than it looks because it took me a little bit of time to get acquainted with this. But you got to lead your targets. And the splash damage is incredible on this cannon, by the way, with infantry. Vehicles, you pretty much got to get them direct on, as you saw earlier in that clip. But here I am, 19, that's nearly 2,000 points I just acquired here in that short 30-second span, guys. But you got to lead your targets, especially when they're running like that. See that guy running? I kind of have to predict where he's going to go, so you kind of got to be smart about where you want to launch this thing, this huge cannon shell from the air. So it is challenging, and it's a lot of fun, and it's rewarding when you pull off, you know, like triple kills, and you kind of look around for the enemy team to spawn, and you see them all spawn, and you know they're all lighting you up with Stingers because they're pissed as hell, you know, when they're getting spawn killed. You know, every few seconds they're switching their engineer class. Here I am taking out vehicles. You can see it's not easy to get kills with vehicles in this thing. You got to hit it pretty much dead on. But with infantry, you got a little more leeway in terms of splash damage. And again, I prioritize when I'm attacking ground units. I'm going after infantry because they're my biggest threat to me. And if I can address them, then maybe I can move on to a vehicle as a secondary target. But I'll say right off the bat, your number one threat's the jet. If you got an enemy player that's an excellent player with jets, chances are your survivability is almost going to be nothing in the AC-130. So you got to have a good jet player on your side defending the mothership, so to say. You know, whatever he can do, even if he's not better than the other guy, if you can just keep him distracted and keep him off you, then you stand a chance to address the guys with all the Stingers. Here I am in the 40mm cannon section. As you can see, it doesn't have any kind of FLIR type vision. It's pretty much just raw visuals that you can zoom in with or zoom out with, but that's it. So it's a little more difficult to get kills with this, but I find with this position you can get infantry a lot. But I was saying about the jets, though. They're very difficult for you to do anything in the AC-130. If the other player's got a good, if they're beasting it up in the jet, you're pretty much done. You will get destroyed, strafed so quick, particularly if you're not working in conjunction with your gunner. If you're not doing that, you stand no chance in hell, and you'll be like, well, this thing's crap. Which is initially what a lot of things I was hearing from people about the AC-130 is that, you know, it's not that good, it's this and that, you know, it's weak, it gets shot down quick. Well, yeah, you're a big fat target in the air orbiting over the battlefield, which anybody and their mother can shoot a Stinger at you, guided shells, javelins, aircraft strafing you, helicopters shooting at you. I mean, I've had the attack helicopter take me out. I mean, you got multiple guys that can shoot anything at you, and you only got two sets of flares, and that's it. So this thing can get shot down really quick. Particularly if the other team's not working in unison or addressing the threat. So bear that in mind, and I'll show you some clips about how easy this thing is to take out. As you can see, pretty much every time I get killed, it's from Stinger fire. There I was showing the players I was playing against. This gameplay is on my server, guys, the One Windshear server. I just renewed it again. So feel free to game on there. I try to limit the amount of kicks, but I'll admit to right off the bat today, I had to kick one guy. I was just a god in the jet, and I just had to get some footage out here. So unfortunately, I feel terrible for doing it, but I had to kick him because we just stood no chance. And I was like, you know what? I've been waiting over a day to get in this thing, and right off the bat, I've got this godlike jet player. I'm like, yeah, I know you've got 12,000 kills in jet, buddy, but go in another lobby and figure it out. You know, right now I'm trying to figure this thing out. But, you know, once it got the learning curve down here again, it's all about predicting where the enemy is. And having this, you know, definitely the rear gunner position's more deadly, I think, than the front gunner position. Because mainly is having this kind of FLIR vision really allows you to identify the players. You notice every time I see him, I spot them. That helps me with my other gunner position because obviously he doesn't have the advantage I do in terms of my visual thermal vision. So anytime I see a player, I spot him so my other gunner can pick him out visually. So now from the receiving of this, you know, you got this AC-130. And also bear in mind, I'll show you some clips here in a minute too. The enemy can parachute out of this thing. It's like basically an Amtrak in the air. So when you're playing Rush, they're bailing out of this thing left and right. They're getting behind you. So that's what I like about Rush. That was a genius move on DICE's behalf because that little thing just changed the complete feel of Rush. No more is it just a linear game. Now you're basically you're having a 360-degree battle. So here they are parachuting in. It always feels like they're in your spawn. It's none of this waiting for them to come to you. They're already there, you know, with this vehicle. So again, if you don't shoot this down right away, you're going to be getting just destroyed by the team just from that perspective alone, allowing them to kind of as a mobile spawn point in the air. And, you know, shooting anything I can, you know, your air superiority is very important in Rush gameplay. If they've got you know, their jet up, their A-10, you know, helicopters, you're not going to win any game. It doesn't matter if it's Conquest or Rush, but it's even more so vital now with that spawn point ability. And obviously only the attackers have the AC-130 on Rush. The defenders do not have that. So you can see here, I was just doing what I can, take those guys out, and just left this little gameplay in here because I shoot at some more stingers here in the minute when the AC-130 responds. The SG-553 is incredible, by the way. I was pulling off some deadly long-range shots with this gun. It felt like an assault rifle to me. I understand there's been a lot of changes in the patch regarding gun balancing and stuff. I'll get to that as it comes. I haven't had a chance to really explore all that. But immediately right off the bat, the SG-553 with no grip and heavy barrel has some... it can reach out and touch you, that's for sure. But again, here you can see, particularly when you have other ground units working with you, just shoot stinger after stinger. I mean, this thing, this was actually my number one weapon in this gameplay was a stinger because I got so many air kills with this thing. You got to keep the pressure on those units with that. So expect that. As you can see there I am getting baseline best weapon being the stinger. So this last clip I'll show you, this is the last map I was playing on. I don't quite have the map names down yet. I think this was one of the desert maps. But again, here I am in the anti-air position here. It's basically just like the AA turret that you're used to on the ground in terms of the fire rate and the capacity and the overheat time, but it's still effective. Here I am disabling the frog foot. But it does take a lot of bullets to put vehicles down. What's difficult about it is when you're sequencing between ground targets and then realizing you're getting shot from the air. And this is actually my first real gameplay in the AC-130. I got a triple kill right here, which you'll see the gameplay kind of freeze here, and that's me unlocking a trophy. I think you get a trophy, the first genuine triple kill you get or something like that. But I got the Death from Above trophy, but that's why the footage kind of froze up. But what I like most about this, you'll see this in the next clip, is about how this really involves you in the... It just immerses you more in teamwork with Battlefield 3 because you're in direct communication with your ground units and your squad or even your team if you go to team chat. And you can pinpoint where your team needs air support. You really couldn't do that before. At least I couldn't do it in a jet. You know, when I'm flying around 400 knots, you know, trying to get a, you know, an angle of attack, you know, I've only got maybe a several seconds of air exposure to kind of give whatever limited fire support I can. I mean, I'll admit I was pretty much useless in a jet. But with this, it changes everything. And I directly have the ability to give direct pinpoint fire accuracy and air-to-ground support to my teammates. When you're in Rush, you know how difficult that can be. Hey, the enemy's encamped on position Bravo. Clear them out. They're on behind that ridge. You know, I look, I zoom in, I pinpoint, identify where they're at, and you'll see in this next footage, you know, how I address that. So communication becomes even more of a vital tactic in this gameplay. Here's that base position Echo over there. On Conquest is where you secure the AC-130. There it is right there. Again, look at the size of this map. And I think this is the biggest battlefield map they made. I mean, just every little base is almost a map in itself. But here I am. There's my teammate Apasky back there telling me where everybody's at, saying, hey, I've got multiple targets on Alpha over here. There's some embedded everywhere. I need help. You know, I can watch him. I can see if there's anybody around him. I can relay to that to him. I can give him air support. You know, it really makes this game just incredibly fun that way. I was having a lot of fun. Again, the most fun I've had playing this game. And all of us were in complete agreement. We're all highly experienced Battlefield 3 players. We were all saying this is like the excitement, or our heart rates are pumping up like Call of Duty. Just an absolute blast to play Rush on this. By far more enjoyable than any other Rush, you know, maps I've played on before, because of this one vehicle. Now I'll cover more depth about the game and the maps in my next videos, but I just wanted to cover the AC-130 here, show you that it's not invulnerable. However, it is lethal, and you got to know how to use it. You know, you got to know your weapon types. You got to be, you know, working in conjunction with a gunner, your other gunner, knowing about your flares, knowing about the anti-air turrets on it, keeping your, you know, you still got to keep situational awareness with this. If you get zoned in and tunnel vision on one thing, just trying to kill one guy, you're going to miss a big picture, and more likely you'll get taken out. So, yeah, here we are moving on to the next series of bomb sites. You can just survey the battlefield. Lots of fun. This is a 40mm cannon position, so it's a lot less weak. But I hope that kind of exposed you guys to what you can expect to see next week when this is released. I'll have more footage to come here about the individual game modes and maps and weapons as well, in terms of the patch details as well. But if you're having any doubts about Armored Kill, put them to rest right now, because it is beyond belief how good this content is. And it'll certainly keep us interested for months to come, for our next release of content in December within game. But this is Windshear, guys. Please like and subscribe to the video if you enjoyed the content. I got one more triple kill here coming up, and I'll have more to come.